but just don't know how much. Tax increases are never easy to obtain or do one like that. In Shelby County, if you raise your tax rate more than 10%, it requires 9 votes on 13 member county commission. And I don't think we can get, I don't think there's 9 votes for a 10% increase. So it certainly will not be that much as far as a 10% increase. But as we get our revenue projections in and our spending projections in, then we'll be able to get a little bit more clearer picture of where we are with that. As far as education is concerned, education is the issue of our times, and it should be. Education should be the priority of every elected official. Nothing more important than the education of our children, and we need to make sure that we educate our children appropriately. Now, I emphasize appropriately. I certainly don't like the way that we got where we are with the education system today. We're merging, we're taking two large systems and merging into a larger system. Really, that runs contrary to the prevailing wisdom on how best to educate. The professionals in this area will always tell you that when it comes to education, smaller is better. And we are running contrary to that, taking two large systems and creating a larger system. If you look at cities of Birmingham, Chicago, well, not Chicago, that's not a good example, but Boston, those are all cities that have several school districts within their community. And that's the direction we need to go. I'm sorry, the municipal school system plan didn't work. And I don't know if legislatively that can be fixed, but the judge says that under our Constitution, the way that our Constitution is designed, we can't do that. So we are, at least as of now, faced with a unified school system. We'll see how that kind of fleshes out in the future. But I serve on the Transition Planning Committee that came up with Board of 72 recommendations for containing cost while unifying the school system. And if the school board, and they are just recommendations, the school board can accept them or they can just choose to ignore them. But if they would embrace those 72 recommendations, and in addition to that, start looking for other school building level savings that can be achieved, it could take that proposed deficit of $57 million and bring it down to as much as $35 to $40 million. $35 to $40 million is still a lot of money. It's not as much as $57 million. But at this point, we have not seen the school board really embracing the recommendations to the extent that they need to realize the savings potential that is there with our schools. We in county government asked the school system to provide us their budget by the middle of January, which was 2 days ago. They haven't done it yet. We want that school budget so that we can start projecting the overall budget for next year and start planning our financial arrangements accordingly. Just as an aside,